2014-16, the Bailey case. Staff, if you would please present this case.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Particular request we have at hand is a request to go from residential zoning to manufacturing zoning. The reason that this particular request is before you is ultimately the applicants have been operating or been involved in the operation of a business since the early 1970s, which makes it, in our opinion, legal nonconforming. But to try to obtain a zoning that better reflects those current uses and also for potential marketing uses is why I believe that we're here. So the applicants are requesting a change in zoning from a residential to a manufacturing M2. Now, I did have two handouts for you, one that detailed the TRC's recommendation. The other one that did give out the applicant's letter of intent, that was just inadvertently not included in your packet, but I do want you to just be aware of that and have that for your records. The update that I wanted to speak to you about since the Planning Commission's work session last Monday was that the applicant and the zoning administrator and I have continued to work on the various classifications of their property. The business, Bailey Equipment Company, has 3 to 4 primary and accessory uses associated with it. The one that was causing us the most concern was that of a salvage yard or a salvage operation. With that, we've learned from the applicant and their agent that really is not something they want to continue, nor was it something they really heavily did in the past. And so with that use being essentially not on the table, that opens up some options for them to consider a lesser zone. With that, they've looked at those lesser zonings, which dominantly the discussion was CC and CH and M1. And I believe that they have indicated that they would be willing to accept an M1 zoning rather than an M2 zoning, because that salvage operation has now been taken off the table, so to speak. So I'll be happy to entertain or try to answer any questions that you might have, but that is the biggest update we have, is kind of a drop in a zoning considered for this case from M2 to M1. The applicant's agent is here. Should you have any additional questions, I anticipate her to speak. But otherwise, that update is really the substantial one that I wanted to make sure that y'all are aware of, is that drop to an M1 ceiling for the consideration.
Thank you. Are there any questions for the staff? There being none, is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak in favor of this request?
Business at this location since 1971. Throughout these years, he's attempted to be compliant. The area was rezoned in 2006 to residential. However, he has continued to support the business. He has obtained his operational tax licenses throughout the years. He has had two wells installed on the property, which he has the health department certified. The installation has been properly. He has in all respects attempted to be compliant. The only thing that cannot be compliant on is the zoning. So he's asking that the legal non-conforming use be changed so that he has a commercial zoning to reflect the business that has been conducted there of a portion.
Are there any questions?
What kind of business is he
conducting? It's a heavy machinery parts. So he takes widgets and sells them to others.
That's all he does on the property?
Yes.
So there's no salvage yard or anything?
No, there's no salvage yard. No intention. What he does is he buys parts, new and used, from other dealers, from the manufacturers, from the aftermarket manufacturers, and sells them to others.
Sure.
Go ahead,
understanding is regardless of what the zoning is, you will be allowed to continue to run business that you're running uninterrupted. That is correct?
That's what I've been informed.
Right. So the zoning is for some future use or the potential to sell or?
All of those, but part of it is the desire to be completely legally compliant. Right. Have the zoning reflect the activities that have been conducted there for years.
You are legal. You're not illegal. Your business is legal. It's just the zoning got changed. No.
Right.
No fault on your.
I would like to have the zoning changed to reflect.
But changing of zoning opens the door for everything that's in that category to one day be put in there or another owner put it in there, and it's sort of like laying a blank check out there.
Well, that's the purpose of a planning commission, is to help balance those goals. What I will say is that although the area zone residential, it is not residential. Land across the highway is timberland, where there's logging going on. Behind it is, if you will, the business of solar, because there's a church that's directly behind the business. And across the dirt road, is what is, in essence, agricultural land. There's about 40 acres there. And I believe there's just one house on those 40 acres. So it's not inconsistent with the character of the land as is.
You're correct. I feel around up there. And it's, we're looking future.
I understand that.
There you go.
Right. But as I point out, you know, the whole area was just by fiat rezoned residential, and that doesn't even reflect the actual character. Furthermore, that area is located fairly close to the interstate, and there are, of course, a number of commercial operations adjacent to the interstate.
That's all
I have,
Mr. Chairman. All right.
Mr. Chairman,
all right.
I understood staff correctly, the component that's salvage is no longer applicable to
it's not business. Applicable, that is correct.
So are you opposed at all to CC zoning rather than the M2 which was requested in your application?
The issue turns on overnight storage, and the M1 would better accommodate that. My father does not want to rezone and then end up having zoning violation because of the way he conducted business.
All right, any other questions for the speaker? Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there anyone else in the audience that would like to speak in favor of this request? There being none, is there anyone in the audience that would like to speak in opposition to this request? There being none, I will now close the public participation portion and discussion is open among the commissioners.
CC would not allow for outdoor storage. CC, CC would restrict them on their outdoor store, but CH, M1, M2 would allow, those allow for outdoor storage.
Now, what do you know about how you've done more research on the wheel? Which one do you think is more appropriate?
CC.
CC?
My concern is what happens to the rest of this block when whatever is done here is done. And I do believe some non-residential zoning is appropriate, but CC is what I felt like would fit the area best.
Okay, but they won't be able to store it inside.
They will not. That'll be something they will continue to do legal non-conforming wise, but if that ever stopped.
So it'll be grandfathered in with one of the things, right?
As long as they maintain those legal non-conforming rights, but they're trying to go with the scenario of if they lost those, we want to be compliant. Current standards, and that is a weakness of CC versus a CH or an M1, is outdoor storage is restricted in CC. It's more restricted than this.
Okay.
Yes.
So if we go CC, are we going to effectively shut them down? If they can't have the outside, okay. I'm not sure. Because of the grandfather. Okay.
One thing that's unique about this case is it's not starting from scratch. And so they've been operating longer than we've had rules for outdoor storage. So they continue to operate. But should those operations ever cease or that non-conforming status be lost, the new rules would kick in and take effect. And when those took effect, that's where there'd be an issue with outdoor storage. So part of this case is really hypothetical, but they're making an effort not only for marketing, but also to try to be compliant with today's standards. And that's one issue where the CC versus the M1 doesn't agree. Yes.
Any other discussion amongst the commissioners? There being none, I will now entertain a motion from the commissioners.
Sir, did we have, I don't know if anybody, did we have those in opposition?
We do.
Okay, no one spoke for that, correct?
Right.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chairman?
Yeah.
I'll make a motion that we make a recommendation that this be rezoned to the CC. And I just base that on it's not going to perform any immediate hardship. And if at a later date somebody wants to purchase the property, it can be contingent on having a zoning request with conditions. So I think it would be compatible with future use, and I think it would get by with what we have now.
I'll second that.
All right. We have a motion by Commissioner Riker and a second by Commissioner Willis. Any discussion on the motion?
I'd like a clarification. So if I understand this correctly, if this becomes zoned CC, they can continue their operation without the storage in the manner they've always performed.
That is correct.
So this will not have any impact on what we understand their use of the property or intended current future use, foreseeable use may be.
That's right. That non-conforming status, as long as they maintain that they have for years, then that outdoor storage is really not impacted. It's impacted when, you know, a use changes and that non-conformity is lost. One of those triggers, yes, sir.
And that would be when they sold the business or it changed hands, or when would that occur?
We've fleshed out different scenarios. The business would not lose its non-conforming status if they sold it to another business. It would lose it if they stopped operating a business for a year. Then that would not non-conformity would be lost. But the non-conformity is not strictly for Bailey Equipment. It's for any business that operates on that property. So typically our non-conforming standards kick in when you stop operating for a year or when they go to expand. That would trigger a special probably public hearing to expand because that expansion is limited. And also the next most common one is, they stop for a year, they expand a major repair. I think the cutoff is 50% of the value of the business or the improvements on the property kicks in a special approval process. So I call it major repair. Major repair, stopping the use, or expanding the current building, expanding the use. Those are the big three we typically see non-conformings lose their rights on.
All right, any other discussion on the motion? There being none, all those in favor of the motion, please indicate by raising your hand. All right, all those opposed? All right, the motion passes.